Shut up and sit down.
Welcome everybody to another edition of Androids and Alligators. I am your host, A3K. I want to give a big shout out right off the top to give a big shout out to my boy Gutierrez for really sticking it to Wells Fargo and having them cut me a sweet ass check so I can buy all this badass podcast equipment. That's right off the top. First person I want to give a shout out to Gutierrez, thank you very much. My second shout out that I want to give to our newest sponsor, one I'm really happy about, one I'm super proud of. Papa Theo Vaughn. It's just a great hot sauce that goes great on any kind of taco. If you want to put it on your Louis C.K. quesadillas, why don't you put a little sprinkle on your Cheech Marin's chicharrones? Huh? Why don't you pick it up by the Dimitri carton today at your local CVS supermarkets? Or supermarkets. Thank you. I got the notes here. Joined by me today, my very wonderful, lovely, boy wondery co-host. You guys know him. You guys love him. His name, he goes by the name of Josh Michaels. Josh Michaels, how are you today?
Hello. Good. How are you?
What was that?
Hello.
Is that your radio voice?
This is my radio voice. You don't like it? Hello. How are you?
Can't say I'm in love with it. But you know, I kind of turn
Hello,
on
Hello. How are you?
Hey, how you doing there?
No. Mine's more nasally than that. Hello. It sounds like I'm sick and going
are you still
through puberty.
Sick?
No.
That's another thing we got to get into today.
Got to get through. I recovered from my sickness that turned out not to be food poisoning. After all, I have to make an apology. First off the bat, people have been complaining, saying, why isn't this kid Josh on the podcast doing more improvisational? I've been reading the emails.
I'm getting a lot of them.
I'm getting emails. A lot of $3.99 pizza lovers have been attacking me online.
Yeah,
it's called Pizzagate's a real thing, and I've been getting just ran over, trampled by all these emails. I have to apologize. It was a bug, a stomach bug, not food poisoning. So if you're a fan of $3.99 pizza or an owner of one of those fine dining establishments, I do apologize. Up top, it was a weird bug. It was a weird bug.
Big shout out to $3.99 Pizza Company. Their pizza does not give you food poisoning. Just want to let everyone know that right off the bat. So the first order of business, we got our sponsor out of the way. Papa Theo Vaughn is very delicious hot sauce.
Caliente.
Muy caliente. Not too caliente. It's just that nice, good amount.
Poquito caliente.
Yeah, you put it on your Bill Burritos. I put some on my Bill Burrito earlier today.
Nice.
And it just added the right amount of kick. You know
nice.
What I mean?
Very cool.
So big shout out to our newest sponsor, Theo. Papa Theo Vaughn. We're going to get into the shot. Shot
Look,
song?
I'm not feeling loose yet.
We got to loosen up.
We got to loosen up. Know? And what better way to wet our whistle, grease our wheels with a little bit of whiskey. Big shout out to hopefully a future sponsor of me, just my life in general, Kessler. And I said to him, hey.
I says, hey,
why are we born? Why are we wasting these people's times? Let's pump it up. Let's do it instead of just taking a shot like a boring normal hosting podcast.
Andrew took a shot.
I know the kids want me to do improv. I know that's what people are saying.
All want, man.
And so I got a little song queued up.
We're
on
do
the
it?
Spot right now. I'm going to make what I hope to be a regular segment at the beginning of every episode, a shot before the show song.
The shot song.
The shot song.
And no, we're not talking Lil Jon.
Oh no,
we're not talking that. We're a little bit more creative than that.
Fire up some music for me, DJ.
All right, let's get it going.
See what we got. Okay. All right, all improv. Here we go. All right, just give me 1 second. Trying to find the beat. Okay, here we go. Improv. Improv on the spot. The shot before the show. Here we go. I got this.
You can do it.
Ready?
Get him. Hot fire.
I'm going to pick it back up. Here we go.
It's coming right now.
It's coming back. Wet your whistles. All right. Here we go. It's the shot before the show. We're gonna do some blow. We're gonna get a little sloppy drunk. And we're gonna get real fucked up off of Kessler.
Kessler.
Gonna get real fucked up off of Kessler.
Kessler.
I wanna get so drunk off of Kessler that I get naked and start dancing on the dresser. I wanna meet some ladies and try to impress her. That's what I do, cause I am a professor. Or a doctor.
What kind of doctor?
I'm a Dr. Julius Kessler.
Ooh.
I'm not Dr. Julius Kessler, but I think he's sitting in the corner over there. Julius, Dr. Julius Kessler, is that you?
Well, I say. Are y'all singing about my delicious, delicious, smooth as silk whiskey?
Can I say, it's an honor to be sitting next to you right now. It is an honor. You are truly my hero.
It's an honor to meet you, Josh Michaels.
Thank you. I've been doing work. Have you been singing? I've been putting all over my social media.
Dr. Julius sees everything you do.
Oh, yeah, you...
And he loves the work you've been doing with Julius Kessler. And smooth as silk. You've been telling the people, and I've been telling my people, that you need to get sponsored by
me. Is this a real thing? You're going to sponsor me?
I'm trying my best.
Oh, thank you so much. You know what? Not only is your whiskey smooth as silk, but you have a very silky head of hair, too.
Look at it. It's long and luscious and it's white.
And your mustache.
Ooh, I twirl my mustache. I put a little Kessler whiskey into my mustache every morning. That's how I get that nice little twirl in it. You know,
I like it. I wish I could grow facial hair.
But you can, Josh.
How? Wow.
Look at that fine looking mustache you got now.
It smells like my dad.
It's because I got it from your dad.
Wow.
It's your daddy's mustache.
It's an honor meeting you. They say never to meet your heroes. They say never to do it. But I'm glad I did. My life is forever changed.
Josh, I want you to know something right now.
Holy I'm so starstruck right now.
I want you to know something. Something I've been wanting to tell you for a long time.
Yeah.
Dr. Julius Kessler. He loves you.
Wow,
he loves you and all the little boys and girls who drink smooth as silk.
Thank you so much. That means Kessler. The world to me, Julius. Julius, it's an honor. It's a pleasure to have you stop by. I dare to even ask, but can I share a drink with the man himself?
Well, I say, why wouldn't we?
Wow.
Let's have a little drink to the doctor.
This is an honor. Julius Kessler joined by him in the studio right now. I can't believe this is happening.
I say. I'm like Santa Claus. I just show up and...
Oh, my God. That's an honor.
I'm excited to join you, Josh.
I'm going to cheers you right here.
Oh, let's have a little cheersy.
Your little cheers. Now, don't be offended. I'm going to chase it with some Dr. Pepper, but that's only out of respect for you as a doctor.
Lord knows you need a little bit of chase.
Yeah, I know. I don't want to offend you. A lot of people say that... Like it's offensive because it means that I don't like the taste of your whiskey. I love the taste of your whiskey.
I'll say, enjoy my whiskey however you like.
Can I ask you this? I feel like your whiskey was made to go with Dr. Pepper. Like you did it on purpose.
I'm a doctor and game respects game.
Wow. Game respects game. Cheers, sir, to you.
Cheers to you.
Man. Mm.
And all the little boys and girls.
Oh my God, that is really good.
Don't hog the Dr. Pepper, boy.
Oh, wow. So good, man. I mean, doctor. It's such a, like I said, I can't say it enough. Honor, pleasure for you to be here, be sitting this close to the man himself. I have one question for you.
Yeah.
One last question.
Boy, go in and spit it on now.
I'm a huge fan of your brand. I love what you do. I love what you sell. I'm buying what you sell. I'm picking up what you're putting down, drinking what you're bottling up. Let me ask you this right now. Can you be candid with me?
I can be very
100%
candid.
Honest with me.
100%.
Someone was throwing some shade at me. This is the truth. If you go buy a bottle of Kessler, look at the label. It says it's... Give me one second right here. It says it's, I believe, something around 72.5% grain-neutral spirits, which means it's majority of your whiskey isn't actually whiskey. Is that true?
Well, I say, that's the secret ingredient that we can't really put on the bottle.
No way.
Let's just keep
What's grain-neutral? I mean, I know there's gender-neutral, but I didn't know there was grain. I didn't mean to assume the pronoun of any grain.
Let's just say some grains are... all built
You're
the same.
So progressive. I knew it. People say, oh, that means it's a shitty whiskey. And I say, no, I think Julius, Dr. Julius, can I call you just Julius now?
Is that going to offend you? I'll say I wouldn't have it any other way.
I want to say this, Julius, I think that you're progressive. I think you're really doing the Lord's work. I think you're taking, you know, pronouns and you're expanding it to inanimate objects as well. And I think you're ahead of your time, sir. And I just commend you.
All I want to do is have a good time. And I'm glad that you are having a good time with me and my delicious smooth as silk whiskey.
Wow, go to your local liquor store, grocery store, and you know, if the bottle's dusty, it's because it's been aging there, fermenting there, and it's going to be better.
It might be a little dusty. And it might be on the bottom shelf, but that's because it's top shelf.
Wow, I like that. And if the clerk gives you a funny look, you tell him Julius sent you.
Yeah, Julius Kessler. That's
wow,
me.
That's such an honor. Thanks for stopping by, Julius.
How about you give me a little Julius Kessler, huh?
Just
a little one on the lips.
Well, you smell like whiskey. You have it all in your mustache.
Nah, about say I say. Oh, I thought you loved me, boy.
Oh, no, man. I have a, I mean, fuck it.
Just a little kissy whiskey.
Oh, no. Oh,
just
man.
Just a little. Oh, man. Smoocherini,
huh? Let me just get another big old shot.
Yeah,
go Do you ahead. Want it with the mustache you gave me, or do you want it without the mustache? Mustache.
I'm gonna need you with the mustache on, boy.
Oh no, I can't. I have a.
Just a little.
I got
kiss.
A stomach bug earlier. I was talking about. I thought it was food poisoning. It's not. I can't. I don't want to give you the bug. I would. You have some sweet, juicy lips.
Give me back my whiskey. The interview's over, boy.
I don't want.
Just you don't want to think about it.
Can I give you a blowjob instead?
Nope.
Can I just...
Dr. Kessler is a lot of things, but a blowjob receiver, he is
I'll
not.
Just give you a quick blowjob.
I'm a gentleman, and I deserve a kiss on the lips.
Oh, fine. Okay, fine, but I'm not going to be really into it. You might get sick, and I'm just warning you.
It's worth it.
All right, come here. All right. Lay it on. Do I lay it on you, or you lay it on me?
I prefer to be the bottom.
Oh, man. Oh my God, you're so fucking juicy. You're just excreting Kessler from your pores.
That they don't call me Dr. Julius
oh
Kessler
my God.
For nothing.
I mean, they say never meet your heroes. Oh, but I
best be going now, boy.
I had a great time.
I enjoyed the kiss.
I gotta get
the
back.
Most.
I gotta get back to this.
I love the song. I love you. I love you the most.
I love you, man. Appreciate
I can tell
you.
that kiss told me a lot.
Oh, God. Well, I'll see you, man. You just stay smooth as silk. You stay smooth.
You want to know how we got that catchphrase?
I don't really want to know.
I can tell you how we got the catchphrase.
Please don't tell me.
I got the catchphrase.
You already kind of ruined this experience.
I've been told my kisses are smooth as silk.
Oh, well. I mean, you heard it here first, folks.
They don't call me Dr. Julius Kessler for nothing.
Oh, man. He's got...
I best be going now, boy.
All right. Yeah, I'll see ya. Hey, maybe don't pop in. Maybe call before you come back.
I'm like Santa Claus. I show up whenever, wherever.
Oh,
I'm like
God.
Shakira. Are you familiar with Shakira?
I mean, I'm a fan of her.
Whenever, wherever. We're meant to be together.
Oh, man. Well, have a good one. Be safe. You didn't have too much to drink, right? You're good?
Dr. Kessler does not drink too much.
All right. Well, I'll catch you later, Julius. Mr. Dr. Julius, thank you. Have a good one.
I'll be seeing y'all on down the road.
Oh, God. That guy was a monster.
What was that, dude? He just took the mic from me. He didn't even...
I think he tried to have sex with me.
He was talking about kissing? I'm glad I didn't get in on that.
Yeah.
Because he kind of, when you weren't looking, but he kind of gave me the finger like, you join in on this. Like he like did the come hither finger.
Right, right.
And I just went to the bathroom. But
yeah, he was very aggressive. It started off great. I was a huge fan. I'm still a huge fan, though. That's the thing. I'm a huge fan. I still love him.
How was the kiss?
I still love him. It was like two dads at a soccer game. Like, hiding
with
from
mustaches?
Their wives. Yeah, with mustaches.
Can you take
like
that mustache off now?
Hiding from, I'm sorry. Hiding from their wives
you look,
in the bathroom.
Oh, you look normal now.
Like, it just felt like, it felt like infidelity. It felt like secrets. It felt like.
It looked uncomfortable. I could see it on your face. You didn't want to. And he was like way too into it. I'm just glad he's gone. And I hope he doesn't come back for a long time.
But I do want more whiskey.
You're going to have to pay the piper.
You have to pay the man, the Julius man.
Oh, Jesus. Oh, well, now that was a nice open to the show. I didn't even know we had a drop-in guest. I feel like the show's off the rails now because he came in and tried to molest us, or specifically molest me. But how? Other than that, how's your week been, Andrew?
I've had a good week. I know it's kind of like dad hit mom, and it's kind of awkward right now. But we're just gonna push right through it.
Oh man,
I had a good week. I had a really good week. I went to.
Did you get molested by your hero?
I did not get molested by my hero. I did go to some concerts though. I've seen a lot of my heroes, which is cool. Mm. I went to a lot of concerts, festivals. I've kind of been nonstop on the concert train. One band I seen. Man, I saw Thursday on Tuesday. That was a treat.
That's confusing.
Yep. I also saw Minus the Bear on Wednesday. Another great, great band. Last weekend was a festival called When We Were Young.
Okay.
And that was like a two-day festival. Morrissey, AFI, Taking Back Sunday, Alkaline Trio, Silver Sun Pickups, The Get Up Kids, Saves the Day.
That sounds like a lot of music.
A lot of music. Not to mention, I went to Lake Havasu for a bachelor party on a Thursday. I left Saturday morning at 6 a.m. to go to the festival day one on that Saturday. Woke up at 6 a.m., 4.5-hour drive to get back to my house.
Did you drink it all out there on the lake?
Dude, not only did I drink, it was like a river, so we had a boat.
So it was more like Lake Have a Brew?
Ooh, I like that.
Yeah, have a brewski.
I made some stew. Lake Have a Stew is what I called it.
Lake Have a Stew. I like Lake Have a Brew better. We could have just you could have just acknowledged it and kept moving forward instead of backtracking. But here we are. We're back.
There was actually a restaurant called Have Some Soup.
Wow, you're being real greedy. You're being a Lake Have a Jew right now. I'm gonna need you to move the story forward, please.
So we went to Lake Have a Stew.
Do you think these audience members have time?
Do you have time? Do they have time for you to
just go back and like make decent puns?
I'm just trying. There was a restaurant called Have Some Soup.
It was called Have Some Soup.
Yeah,
you just said that you're going back again.
No, but that was an actual restaurant that I looked at while I was on the river.
Oh man, I had a great time drinking Mountain Dew.
All right,
we going to Lake Have a Dew. Okay,
right. Come on now. That's a dead meme now, dude.
Yeah.
No, it was a great time. We had a blasty blast. And now I'm going to go see one more show and then I'm done with shows, I think, for a while.
Forever?
For a little while.
For a long while?
Maybe like a couple weeks.
That's not a long while.
It's a little while. But, how was your week, man?
What did solid, you get into? Solid.
Back to solid dumps.
Back to solid dumps. So I had a little bit of a stomach virus. I don't know if anybody really cared. I thought it was food poisoning. Turned out to be a bug that someone gave me. And I'm very aware of who the culprit is. And let me tell you this right now. I'm not happy.
Was it a horse?
Could have been. Could have been a horse. Could have been
chicken.
Could have been a chicken. Could have been any ranch animal.
A ranch animal.
Yeah.
Ranch
animal. And I'm not talking about Hidden Valley. I'm a big fan. I'm a big fan of Hidden Valley.
You were the ranch man.
I call it the soup of the day, okay?
The soup du jour.
The soup du jour, the creamy, the creme de la creme, the Hidden Valley.
You found the Hidden Valley.
Oh, it was hidden, and I found it.
And now you're just frolicking.
And I know who the culprit is. I know about where it all happened, and I'm working on shutting it down. You're going to shut down the whole ranch. Shutting down the ranch. I'm shutting it down.
Is this a Hidden Valley ranch?
No, okay. I would never. No, I didn't. I'm not shutting shit down.
Is it somewhere beyond the Thousand Islands?
Wow. Come on, honey. I'm being real absurd right now.
Oh, come on. You planned that one. Why did you plan that one, dude? That was too good.
They call me a wordsmith. I know people have been. I've been reading the emails. They're saying, why doesn't that little tight boy do more improv? And I say, this is me. This is me trying. But I'm not liking it.
But I'm enjoying it.
I got a little virus. I'm better now. Taking solid dumps. And I narrowly escaped my first crazy homeless person, but I've been going to a Starbucks very frequently recently, and I picked it out because it's in a good area. It's got a good setup, good people. There's a few homeless people, but they mind their business. They're very quiet.
They're just there.
This, oh my God, this, I met a gentleman today. He had scars, covered in scars all over his face.
So he wasn't a gentleman.
He kept asking me a lot of questions about my computer.
And oh, he had an eyeball on it.
He kept going over. He kept touching it.
Touching your stuff.
Yeah.
What happened?
And he kept saying, "I used to have one just like this." And he was petting it. And I said, "Sir,
he petted your computer.
He did. I said, "Sir, don't do that. Don't do that." And then he sat back down, put on headphones, and then laughed loud, like very audible. He was a crazy man. He was crazy. And so I packed up and I left. I got out of there.
You know what's funny? We actually have that homeless man in the studio today.
Is it the same guy? I don't think it's the same guy.
Homeless man, can you go ahead and come on and pop on in here?
No, I don't want him to be here right now.
Well, here he is.
I'm gonna pack up. I'm gonna head out.
Hey, I saw you at
Wow, this is
weird.
I
saw you at Starbucks. Got that computer still?
No, I was borrowing it.
Do you want to know why I got these scars?
I was borrowing it from a friend. I was borrowing it.
You're borrowing
the computer. The computer I had.
I had one just like it. You know that, right?
Yeah, you told me.
You want to know how I got these scars?
I borrowed that computer. Sorry.
Why don't you? Can I see it? Can I see it?
Sorry. How'd you get those scars? I was borrowing that computer. By the way, just want to let you know that.
You ever been to a cockfight?
Like with chickens?
No.
Oh no. No, but I met a doctor recently. Who seems like that's something that would be right up his alley.
This is the thing. You tie a knife to your cock, and you fight the other one.
Wow. How'd it get on your face, though? I'm sorry I asked. I apologize. That's very rude of me. I don't know why I'm laughing. It's so inappropriate. I apologize.
Sorry. Okay.
Do you still participate in these fights at all?
I lost.
Hey, I'm sorry I judged. I'm sorry I judged you.
I'm just a little. Do you got any meth? There's like meth.
I borrowed that meth that I had last time I saw you. I borrowed it.
Do you have any meth?
I do have some meth. I do have some math. I have some math for you right now.
I like problems.
I can tell you're a very. I can tell that you have a lot of problems. I can tell you're a fan of problems.
Love them. Yeah.
Let me give you one problem to solve.
Yeah.
Okay?
What's that? What do you got?
Your life, buddy.
Mm-hmm. What's that?
You know what? I lied to you earlier. I'm gonna be very transparent. I don't know why I'm being rude. I apologize. I didn't borrow that laptop. That's my laptop.
I know you're lying.
I don't know why I'm laughing. It's your face, dude. You have a very fucking weird face, and I apologize. But I feel like that was your choice getting in those cockfights. You didn't have to do that. You did it on your own, and and you're trying to make me feel bad about it. And
no.
I really don't. But I do feel bad for judging you as a human being.
You should feel bad.
Do you want my laptop?
No, not anymore.
I was gonna do it like a sneaky thing where I was gonna offer it to you out of politeness, and then you were gonna say no, and I was gonna insist, and then not actually give it to you.
Okay, I'll take it.
Oh, okay. I was borrowing it. I gotta go, man. I got other stuff to handle.
I gotta find some math.
Yeah, well, I know there's some.
Ask me a math question. Ask me a math question.
Okay. How many?
Seven. I'm out of here.
Oh man! Wow. It was
I don't know
right
why
answer.
You invited that guy.
You invited him.
You wanted him here. I thought that's why you got into the story.
Oh man.
He's a weirdo. He talked very very low. I hope we got him on the microphone.
Oh God. Oh man, he's got problems, but apparently he likes them. So
he likes math. He was a math head.
I'm gonna ask you something. I know you can't be feeling up to par. I know you had something very traumatic happen to you recently.
You really want to talk about this here?
I feel like there's no better place. I feel like it's been bothering you. It's been weighing on you all week, and I don't feel like I can hang out with you because it's weighing you down so much that you're a bummer to be around. To be honest, to be frank. And I just want you to get it off your chest. That way we can move forward.
I just felt really bad, man. I did something on accident. I didn't mean to do this. And had I known that was going to happen, I wouldn't have done it. But I stepped on a lizard.
I feel
last
like that's
week.
What. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to step on the reveal. But I feel like that's what an accident is. Doing something that if you had you known you were going to do it, you wouldn't have done it. But you did it. That's an. I feel like that you just explained.
It was an accident. I feel really bad. I stepped on this lizard. And I felt really shitty about it. I was coming home, and usually lizards like to, I haven't seen them in a while, lizards like to hang out on my stoop. They kind of just,
there's a bush that they live in, and they come out, and they just want to soak up some rays in the sun, you know, maybe some do some lizard push-ups. And I was coming home, I was rushing, and I just hopped up on the stoop, and I stepped on one, and I seen him writhe in pain and just go back into the bushes, like spinning. Like,
well, let me tell you this. I know you were hoping to to kind of like reconnect, kind of like solve that problem, bury that burden. Unfortunately, you know, I can't find a lizard. But what I can do is I've been reading a lot of books.
Okay.
I read a lot of books, and I feel like the best way to get over it is to reenact that moment. You know, I'll be the lizard. I'll be the lizard just to help you.
Okay. Yeah, okay. You're the lizard.
I'll be the lizard to help you. But I feel like, okay, I'm gonna need some ambiance. I can't just do it here with you.
Okay. Where do you?
I've been reading a lot of books.
Okay.
A lot of them.
How many books?
Can you be more impressed when I tell you? I'm gonna tell you again. I don't like the way you did it. It was disrespectful. I'm gonna tell you one more time. I've been reading a lot of books. Wow. Nothing. I don't like it. It's not easy reading a book.
Reading a lot of books.
And this is what they say. So, okay, here we go. I'm going to walk you through this right now.
Okay, we're here.
You're coming home. Reenact it. Do you want to talk to him and see how he's doing now?
I mean, I would love to.
Okay. First of all, let me just soak in this ambiance. Let me channel. Maybe I can channel this lizard right now. Maybe I can channel him. Okay, I'll do my best. Here we go. Channeling. I know everyone's asking for improv, so here we go. I'm gonna channel him. I'm gonna channel his voice, his essence, what I believe him to be.
Okay, well, we're in the jungle, so.
Okay. Go ahead.
Lizard, is that you?
Hey, yeah, it's me. Hey, what's up?
Lizard, oh my God.
I don't feel like he sounds like that.
He sounds like a Kermit the Frog.
Okay, let's try it again.
Maybe something that's not copyrighted already. All right.
Okay, hold on a second. Okay, hold on.
Lizard, is that you? You're breaking my heart right now.
No. Okay, let me go. So, one more time. I'm not going to fuck it up this time, I promise.
What's that? Lizard, is that you?
Hey, Andrew.
Something non-copyrighted.
That was different. You didn't hear the tonal pitches and changes?
It sounded a lot like Kermit the Frog.
Hey, Andrew. No, that's a baby.
That's a baby lizard. It was kind of a baby lizard.
Hey, I can't. Let me try. Okay. Last time. I promise. I know people are getting tired of this. I'm going to do it right this time.
Lizard, is that you?
Hello. It is me, the lizard.
A French lizard. I've always wanted to meet one.
The language, the accent is not important. It might change a lot. It's just who I am as a person.
Whatever I want it to be. Just not Kermit the Frog.
Right.
Well, lizard.
Are you the man that stepped on my tail?
I am the man that stepped on your tail, and I felt really bad about it this whole time.
You should feel very bad.
I wasn't looking when I stepped.
You should feel very bad.
When I stepped, I wasn't paying attention, and I stepped on you, and I saw you were in a lot of pain, and I just want you to know from the bottom of my heart, I am sorry. I didn't mean for that to happen.
You ruined my life.
Your whole life?
My entire life. Most lizards, they can grow their tail back. But not me. Do you know how there is an ancient Greek guy, Achilles?
Yes. I'm familiar with Achilles.
Yeah, his Achilles heel. I have an Achilles tail, my friend.
Oh, no. I've never heard of Achilles tail.
So my tail does not grow back?
So now you're not a lizard anymore. What are you?
Oh, not a lizard, not a provider for my family.
I ruined your family?
You know, my wife has not looked at me the same way since that day. My son puts his tail between his legs like it's a male human penis. And he plays with it. And it just makes me feel like...
In front of you.
Just makes me feel like less of a lizard.
Well.
Do you know what it's like when your son put his tail in between his legs like a penis? Do you
not. I feel like
I don't know that feeling.
You know when he uses little lizard hands on his penis and it's all it's oh man.
Well, is there any kind of surgery or anything I can?
So I could get it. I could get a
get it back.
I could get a tail transplant.
Can we get a tail transplant going?
It's a possibility.
I'll try to go GoFundMe. We can get that going.
Cause it's a possibility. Better my life.
Oh, you're Mexican now. I love your accent, Mr. Lizard.
I am having an identity crisis because of my
tail. Irish now.
Because of my tail.
Well, we're going to do, I'm going to do everything I can. I'm going to start a GoFundMe.
You know what? It's too late.
Why?
Mijo. It's too late. Stop using your tail as a penis.
Hey, how'd your kid get in here?
Ay, 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 Andrew.
Well, we moved to a different part of the jungle. It sounds like the same part of the jungle.
Ay, you ruined my life.
You know, Mr. Lizard, again, I can't say it enough.
But you ruined my life.
Well, what do you want me to do about it, Mr. Lizard?
Can you imagine? For 1 second, can you imagine? Your balls, your penis.
Sorry, we moved to another part of the jungle.
Why did it get quiet all of a sudden?
I don't know, we moved to a different part of the jungle. Sorry. I'm in a tent now. Okay.
Your genitals were no longer there. Can you imagine?
I can't, I'm sorry.
But everybody says, oh, they'll grow back. It'll grow back. Just be patient. Patience is like tails. I don't have any. I don't have one.
I'll tell you what. I'm going to start a GoFundMe. We're going to get you that fucking tail.
You can start at go fuck yourself, okay? You can start at go fuckandrew.com/... Who gives a fuck about you? Okay? You can start a go fuck me page. Okay? I'll put in lots of money. Maybe my son will start playing with himself. And maybe people will donate money because they feel bad for me. Well, guess what? I don't need their money. I don't need your pity.
You're breaking my heart.
Why don't you start? Ego, fuck you. .com account and title it. I fucking hate lizards.
Well, I don't hate lizards. I love lizards, and I'm sorry I hurt you.
Apology accepted. I am forgiving you.
What's your name, by the way?
My name is... I forgot my name because of my tail. Because they used to call me lizard long tail. We have Indian names in lizard culture.
Oh, so you're not that anymore.
No, they call me...
I was calling you Titanus. I don't know if you heard me call you that. You know, from the Power Rangers, there was a Dragonzord.
It's not my name.
I was calling you Titanus. But then I realized it looks like tit anus. So.
My name is Roger.
Roger? Again?
Roger the Tailless.
Roger the Tailless. Well.
The Tailless Roger.
I'm going to make you a little plaque, commemorative plaque, made from the plaque of my teeth. And we're going to do everything we can to get you that transplanted tail back so you can go back to long tail.
And, long tail. Long time.
We're going to get you the longest tail we can find, my friend.
Do you know what?
What?
I don't need it. I like being Roger. I like my life.
Oh, so then we're cool then.
Yeah, sure. We're cool.
Well, I want to thank you for coming on the podcast and being a part of this.
Hey, hey, hey.
Yeah, I'm here.
Come here.
I'm here.
Come here.
Okay.
What do you need to tell me?
Go to www.gofuckyourself.com/ I forgive you.
All right. Well, that was weird.
Did that help you at all?
It did.
Do you feel better?
I thought.
Can I be very 100% honest with you? I blacked out.
Did you?
I blacked out 100%.
I felt like I was talking to a lizard the whole time.
I blacked out. I at first I was, oh, these weird voices, you know, like Kermit the Frog voices were coming to my head. And I was like, no, I'm trying. Let me surrender. Yeah. Let me surrender.
Give yourself up, dude.
And I gave myself up and I blacked out. How did it go?
I think it went well. He told me to go fuck myself, and I offered to start.
That's very rude.
A GoFundMe, and he said I can go fuck myself.
Whoa!
And I can go to www.gofuckyourself.com. / Andrew. So you can go to my personal page.
Did he end up forgiving you at all?
I think he did.
Seems a little vague.
A little Vegas.
A little vague. Wow.
A little vaguey.
Well, I hope you feel better, man.
I don't.
Okay.
But I hope I do.
I hope you do too. I really do feel bad for you. He sounded like a very confused guy. Like he didn't know where he was from anymore or who he was anymore.
Well, he lost his identity with his tail, apparently.
Did he say that?
He did say that.
Okay. I just want to make sure that was clear.
Crystal clear.
Wow. Okay.
Wow. So we're going to change gears a little bit.
This is an emotionally draining episode.
So I'm emotionally drained.
I don't even. Do you think if we just crack the bottle real quietly, just because I need some more whiskey.
Oh, well then help yourself.
But I don't want Julius to come back.
Just keep it low.
Keep it low.
Keep it low.
Okay, you watch. You keep recording.
I'm gonna keep an eye out.
You entertain the people. You entertain the people. You entertain them.
Hey, what's going on? You know what? Actually, this is gonna be a great time to take a little bit of a break, and give a big shout out.
Oh no!
You're gonna call him out.
Oh no! You think he heard that?
He might hear it. I don't want him to come back. Do you want him to come back?
No, no.
I'm gonna take this time to give a shout out to our sponsors for this week. Tapatio Vaughn goes great on any of the Louis C.K. quesadillas, the Bill Burritos. Go ahead and pick up yourself a Dimitri carton at your finest CVS establishments. And let's get back to the show. Josh, I'm going to ask you a question right now. Growing up, did you have a favorite TV show?
100%.
100%.
Absolutely.
We always keep it sexual. Oh.
I'd ride and die for it.
Boy Meets World. You're looking at me with the deepest
Boy Meets World.
Eyes right now.
Yeah.
Why Boy Meets World?
I don't know. I like to think of myself as a season 4 Corey Matthews, looking for his Topanga out there, getting it. I'm a Boy Meets World super fan. I love love. I love love.
Yeah.
And I love the world.
I feel like
and I love boys.
You're a Boy Meets World traveler because you've gone to a couple of Boy Meets World conventions, have you not?
Oh, absolutely. Are you kidding me? I have a booth at one of them.
Oh, you do? What do you what's your booth about?
I sit there and I'll draw you and as a caricature as any one of the Boy Meets World characters you want.
I could be Minkus.
Well, I don't know how to draw Minkus.
So I could be Mr. Feeny.
I can't really draw Feeny.
Oh, okay, I'll just be Frankie.
Can't really draw. Can't really draw that either.
All right, so I'll just be Josh then.
I could draw you, and I could put some curly hair on you, and then you'll be Corey Matthews.
So you can only draw someone as Corey Matthews.
I mean, if you want to be a Andrew with an afro, I could do that too.
Sounds like you're not very good at caricatures.
And the characters also look nothing like you. I just want to warn you.
So it sounds like you're just drawing Corey Matthews over and over.
I can't even draw Corey Matthews. I'm lying. I can't even do it.
It's a stick figure with curly hair
on it. It's just a circle with an afro. And I in the circle, I write...
Corey.
I write your name, and then I write Corey Matthews, right, a.k.a. Corey Matthews, right under. But people love it. People love it.
I enjoyed Boy Meets World growing up. I had a great time with it. I didn't, not as much as you. It's got me through some times because I do believe that there's a Topanga out there for
I'm
going
to tell you this right now. I've said this before on other podcasts, but I feel like there's never time to not say that. Let me tell you something about the world.
Get into it.
Let me tell you something about the fucking world. Sometimes you can hate the world. And sometimes the world can get you down and it can beat you up. But remember that that's the same world that gave you all your friends and all the things you love. Boy Meets World series finale.
Is that a direct quote?
Corey Matthews said that to Josh Matthews. Funny.
Sounds eerily similar.
Maybe I got named after that character. Maybe that character got named after me. We'll keep the line blurry. Wow. Josh Matthews. Has a ring to it.
JM.
And let me tell you this right now. Series finale. Corey says that to his little brother Josh. Nothing. No truer words have ever been spoken on television.
I agree.
I'm glad you agree.
It was almost Rocky-esque.
Well, I think Rocky was Boy Meets World-esque.
Well, it's tomato, tomato.
It's tomato, Topanga. Okay. And you need to get it
together.
Man,
you were on it today, dude.
I'm on something. I might have fucked up channeling that lizard, but.
Well, that's cool. I had a favorite show.
Was it Boy Meets World?
It was not. It was Little Show.
Was it Girl Meets World?
No, it was not. It wasn't that either.
I'm not going to like it.
Home Improvement.
Wow, good show.
Oh, oh, oh.
Wow, is that Tim the Toolman Taylor? Tim the Toolman.
Tim the Toolman Taylor himself.
Tim the Tool Tom Taylor.
Just a simple working man who loves working power class. Tools. He also has his own TV show with his best friend Al Borland, which has a great beard and is sometimes a little bit smarter than him. But it doesn't matter because Tim has the heart.
I love Tool the Tim Time Tom man. Taylor. Tom Taylor, what's the boy's Tom? What's the his son's Jonathan Taylor?
Jonathan Taylor Tom, JTT.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So it's Tim the Tool Man, Jonathan Taylor Thomas. I love
man.
Man.
Yes,
man. Tim yes. the Tool Tom. Yeah, yeah.
Tom the Tool Man Taylor Tom Man.
Jonathan Taylor Thomas.
Yeah. I actually wrote a little song for.
That's how much you love this.
That's how much I love this man.
Can I trouble you? Can I bother you? Nay. Can I request? Did I hear this ditty, this little ditty?
I'm going to play, for the first time ever in Androids and Alligators history, a live performance.
Live performance? Whoa, I can't wait. Hold on. Give me a second.
I got to get my guitar.
Give me a second. Let me get comfortable in my chair. Hold on. Give me a second.
This is very much a love song.
You look nervous. It's a love song. I can't wait. I'm sure everyone out there, everyone else listening can't wait. So let's just hear what this little love song's all about.
All right, here we go. When I had a broken heart, you were the right tool man. You could fix anything. With a Binford tool, you and your trusty companion, Al Borland. No job was too small, or was it? You were the right tool man for me. You were the right tool man for me. You were the right tool man. You were the right tool man. You were the right tool man. When I had a broken heart, you were the right tool man. You and your Binford tools. You even went to your neighbor Wilson for advice. He said, just do what you can. You were the right tool man for me. Oh, 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 oh. You were the right tool man for me. Oh, oh. You were the right tool man. You were the right tool man. You were the right tool man for.
Wow, it sounds beautiful.
I've worked on that for about 1 hour.
It sounds like Tim the Toolman Taylor broke up with you.
Well, when I was going through a really dark time, Tim the Toolman Taylor was the toolman that got me through it. He fixed me, and a lot of home improvement episodes later, and he's got me going.
I had a friend one time who did acid or mushrooms or something like that. Watched Home Improvement, saw the show Tool Time, right? That's what it was called.
Yeah.
On the show, they spilt the toolbox over, and in real life, my friend thought that the tools spilt out of the television.
Oh no!
And he was freaking out. He went around the room picking up all Tim's tools. Yeah, for hours.
That's a good story.
It's crazy. I don't mean to upstage you, but I feel like it's my duty as a co-host.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, I kind of wrote a song about my favorite show as well.
Did you really?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I have it queued up on my phone, if you don't mind if I play it real quick.
I do not mind at all.
Okay, well, let me just pull it up real quick. All right, I got it queued up. You ready? Ready. This is a song I wrote.
I
wrote this song. It's a passion project of mine, project I've been working on for a long time. I'm very nervous to share it with the public.
More than an hour.
Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. Okay. A lot of time.
Okay.
This is a song that I wrote, a little ditty that I wrote for my favorite show.
P. Diddy wrote this.
It's a P. Diddy that Josh Michaels wrote.
But P. Diddy had influence?
It's a P. Diddy.
Is Mace on the track?
Mace on the track. Fire on the track. It's a little song I wrote, little P. Diddy for you.
You
might hear it. I'm going to play it.
I'm excited.
Here we go. Josh, cause Josh is cool. Watch him when we swirl with Josh. Josh, when this boy meets world. It's pretty good, right?
That was the worst thing I've ever heard in my life.
You didn't like it?
All you said was Josh.
No, I don't think you heard it, dude.
When this boy meets world.
I don't think you heard it, dude.
Wait, hold on a second.
I don't think you heard it, dude. Hold on. I'll play it for you one more time. Josh. Stay by me. Because this Josh meets world.
That was even worse than the first time. You laughed.
That's the same song. I laughed out of I was nervous.
All you said was Josh. To the tune of Boy Meets World.
No, but I wrote the song. I spent a lot of time.
I could do the same thing. You watch. Do it again.
Okay, but please don't hurt my feelings. I really did work a long time, and I feel like you're gonna make fun of me. And
I'm not gonna make fun of you.
Here you go. I'm gonna cut you off early. That was bad, and you're making fun of me.
I'm not making fun, dude. That was exactly what I just. Yours is your name is one syllable.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Mine's is two. It's a little harder to work with, but
no, you're making fun of me. That was a song that I worked very hard on. I'm not gonna show you my creations anymore. Do you want to hear it one more time?
I want to hear it one more time.
All right, last time, dude. Please don't make fun of me, dude. I'm laughing because I'm nervous.
Can I make it a duet?
Only if you sing the words with me.
I will.
You promise?
Your words.
You promise?
I swear.
Okay. Only because you promise. When this boy meets world. But I appreciate it. Thank you so much. Thank you. Wow. Big round of applause for Andrew.
We need to get a soundboard in here.
Big round of applause for you.
Let's hear it one more time. I'm just kidding.
yeah. Thank you. I really appreciate your song too, by the way. I'm not. Your song is very beautiful. I just feel like mine had a little bit more production value.
You
were just live.
I actually did it live, and that came from the heart. And it was an emo song for Tim Allen, the Tool Man.
Yeah, yeah. A lot of my lyrics come from my personal life, and I just want Boy Meets World to know. Every word I meant, every word I said in that song.
Well, I mean, every word was just Josh. Well, but
there was Josh meets world.
Oh, I like the ending actually.
It actually goes stand by me when it's Josh meets world. It's very you'll find it. Download it. I'll put it up on iTunes maybe as an individual track. Think it'll sell well. Think people will buy it.
There might be a demand for it.
Wow, don't lie to me.
I mean, I'm just saying. It's whatever the market dictates.
Wow, I just feel free. I feel very free.
I feel good.
I feel very free. I do. I think we open the show with a shot. I'm not going to tell you how to end it.
We're going to have to end it soon.
I'm going
to
give you a little suggestion that we open it with a shot.
Suggest!
I say close it with a shot.
Let's do a shot closing.
Close it with a shot.
Close it with a shot. And then once we hit stop recording, we'll take another one.
Ooh.
Or three, you know. It's just an idea. I'm just spitballing ideas out there. This was a very improv-heavy show. We really didn't have anything planned other than a couple little things. And I had a good time.
And look, you know, I'm already reading the emails right now. They're already coming in. They're already coming in.
This isn't even live yet, but
we're still recording it. But I'm already reading the emails to say, Josh, I know that was you channeling that lizard. I know that was you, and that was bad. I'm reading the emails right now. I'm reading one right now from Josh, Dr. Julius Kessler.
You were 818-927
Julius, Dr. Julius Kessler at gmail.com.
As far as I know, you were the lizard.
But he's saying really mean things, and then I'm, you know what? Maybe I'm just not going to open up on this podcast anymore. Because every time I open up my soul, I sing a song, and then I try to help you get over a lizard you stepped on, you guys make fun of me. I'm out of here, dude.
I can't take it anymore. Josh, please don't go.
No,
don't go.
You're making fun of me.
Do you want to have a shot with your old boy?
All right, I'll take a shot. You're talking about you, right?
Yeah, with me. Yeah, of course.
Julius is
not
coming
Dr.
back?
Julius. No.
Okay.
Of course not. Right. Just be careful how you open that bottle because he might come back.
I don't want him to come back. Just be careful.
All right, I'm gonna open it.
Maybe
he's not on to me. You know what I mean?
You open it. I don't like doing this.
Okay, no. See? He's not even here.
Okay. Let's pour him up. Pour him up full. Little shot-a-rooski.
There we go.
He's not coming back.
Dr. Kessler isn't coming back because Dr. Kessler doesn't even really... Dr. Kessler.
He doesn't. What?
I just said Dr. Kessler 3 times.
No.
I'll say. Did someone call Dr. Kessler?
No.
Oh, Joshy boy. How are you doing? We're going to finish up this podcast with a little bit of shot-a-rooney. The smoothest silk, Dr. Kessler. Why don't you give me another peck on the lips?
You know what?
Why don't you give me a little peck on the lips?
You know what?
Your boy Julius Kessler loved that peck on the lips.
They say to beat a bully.
Oh, this ain't bullying.
They say if you can't beat them, join them.
Join me, Josh.
And
give me a little peck on the lips.
All right, come here, dude.
I'm here.
Come here.
Yeah, I'm here. I'm coming.
Ready?
Coming over. Yeah. All
right.
I'm here.
All right. You there?
I'm here.
I feel you.
I'm here.
Do you feel me?
Oh yeah.
Do you feel me right now?
I feel you.
Okay. Here we go. 3, 2, 1.
Oh, boy. Too much tongue, boy.
Oh, man. I want to say this right now. At the beginning, I didn't feel comfortable with you. Now I feel very comfortable. I apologize.
Well, I'll say it. All it takes is a little bit of Kessler.
I feel like it's the alcohol. I feel like the alcohol's kicking in. I'm getting a little more explorative with my sexuality.
It's them neutral grains.
Neutral grains. I feel neutral.
Yeah.
I feel neutral. That's my boy. I saw a picture of a woman and I saw a picture of a man. I don't care. I'm neutral. I don't have a sexual preference anymore.
70% neutral, baby.
Holy crap. That's what that does.
Smooth as silk.
Smooth. Look at you, you smooth man. I thought you were hitting on me earlier. I wasn't drunk enough yet. Now you're doing it. I get the neutral grains have taken effect. I feel neutral. I feel gender neutral, gender fluid. I feel smooth as silk. Oh, I get the title now.
All people also
bring it in for one
people
more.
Also
bring
say
it in. Bring it in. Shut your sweet, juicy mouth up. Give me that fucking stash, baby. What do people say, Julius? God, open my mind.
Smooth ass milk. Get over here, boy.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
You know, I'm going to dump a little of this all over the... Wait a second.
What's that, boy? I'll say. Did you just catch what I'm pitching?
Wait a second. I'm looking at the bottle of Kessler.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
You look nothing like this Julius on the bottle.
Oh, gotta go.
Wait. Hey! Hey, what the fuck? Get back here!
What's his deal, man?
That... Okay.
Was that not really...
Pick up a bottle...
I've never looked at the guy's face.
You pick up a bottle of Kessler, you see this nice-looking, I'm assuming, Mexican man.
He looks like a doctor.
He looks like a very respected doctor. That guy had scars on his face.
That was the bum!
No, and a shitty mustache.
I knew that mustache was shitty.
He had a weird mustache. Who curls their mustache with whiskey? He probably was just drinking fucking Kessler because that's all he could afford.
That's all he could afford. It all makes sense now.
Oh, my God.
You just got Shyamalan'd.
Wow. He really got me.
And you all just got Shyamalan'd.
He really got me.
I feel bad for you.
Wow. Can we put on an outro song? An outro song. We're going to take a shot. Get loose. I'm going to freestyle a little verse. You freestyle a little verse. Let's close this show out. Let's give the people what they want.
Well, there already is an outro song.
No, I'm not listening to you. How about this? I'll be the android or the alligator, and you can be the other, and we'll have a little song. And I'll be the android, and you'll be the alligator.
But we already have an outro song.
But do you want me to play my Boy Meets World song again?
Do the people want to hear it again?
Look, I can't just keep playing it for free. I'm going to start charging 99 cents per play.
All right.
Let me give you time. But it needs to be a beep, beep, rawr.
All right, so I got it queued up.
I'm ready for that beep, rawr.
I think this is about as beep, beep, rawr as we're going to get. So do you want to be the alligator or do you want to be the android?
Ooh, good question. What do you feel more like right now? I feel like you're like more like an alligator.
I'll be the alligator.
And I'll be the...
Android. Yeah.
All right, let's do it.
Here we go. Let's drop this beat.
Let's try it. Let's try it out. Let's see what we got. Ooh. Beep, beep. Beep, 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 boop. Android. I'm an android.
I'm an alligator.
I'm an android.
I'm an alligator.
I'm an android.
I'm an alligator.
Look, I'm an android, I'm a robot, I'm a drink a lot, I'm gonna get real tipsy, don't miss me, I'm a robot, but don't forget to charge me up, because I'm a robot and I don't give a fuck, I'm a robot that drinks whiskey, you can forget to unplug me.
Yo. So I'm an alligator, don't step to me. I'll bite your lips off with my alligator teeth. Don't mess with me, don't get in the water. I'll make you jump out like a junk wada. I say, don't come to me, cause I just came to play. Fuck the android. This is androids and alligators, baby. And if you wanna mess with me, you can see I'm an alligator, yeah, I'll bite your lips off. Kiss my dick and lick off my lips off.
Oh, it sounds like the alligator's kind of being a little bit of an alligator. Let me tell you that I don't want to push your buttons, but I have a lot, and buttons are what I love pushing and what I love fucking. I'm an android, so I don't fuck nothing. I'm an android, so I don't fuck nothing. I'm just out here representing what I'm touching, rusting away in water. Take me away from the water.
Listen, android, that was kind of cute. You're coming around the water like you're not gonna rust out. I just want you to know, would you eat me out? And when you lick my dick, will you let it sit me out? I just want to make sure that we're on the same level. Come to me like you're talking about being on the not same level. I'm not a rapper. I'm an alligator, bitch. Don't test me.
Look at those teeth, but look at me with my robot feet and my robot beats from the robot street. I'm a robot, so you can program me to be mean. You can program me to be a good rapper. I have a weak bladder, you wanna piss and what splatter. And half of that water you swim in is urine. I hope you're not here to start exploring. Your career as a rapper is over and dead. I'm an android, it's got no brain and no fucking head. I'm just an android.
Now I'm an alligator. You're an ally hater. Come to me like you're drinking Kool-Aid out the heater. You're an android. Make it simple. Wow. Make your ass clap like you're making dimples. And you got hemorrhoids. Did I say that, android? Wow. I'll throw you in the void like you're playing Metroid.
I'm an android. You're an ally hater. I keep it cold like a refrigerator. Beep, boop, bop, boop, boop, bop, beep, bop, boop, boop, bop, bop. Thanks for listening to another episode of Androids and Alligators. I'm your co-host, Josh Michaels. But give it up for the host, the main man, the alligator in this marriage, Andrew A3K Gomez.
Yes, thank you guys. Thank you guys for listening to another episode of Androids and Alligators. Make sure you're downloading on iTunes, Stitcher, Google Play, or wherever you're getting your podcasts from. Rate and review, subscribe, and a big shout out to all of our wonderful sponsors. Special shout out today for
Tapatio Vaughn. Make sure to follow me, your co-host Josh Michaels, on Instagram, Twitter, @_JoshMichaels. Anything else? Anything else we're adding?
You can follow me too. It's me A3K on everything. Just type that in. I'm come up on everything. And